Hi, this is Simon with IQRF. Based on the previous videos, you should have your development set ready and the IQRF IDE installed. This video will show you how you can open, modify, compile, upload, and run your first IQRF application written in the C language. Please note that working with IQRF data control transceivers, which is demonstrated on another video, is even much easier and recommended for most of standard applications. To open the first project, we start with the IQRF startup package. You will go to the application and the C programming. Here you will find different examples that you can use for your application development. There are basic examples, advanced examples, IQ mesh examples, and examples how to work with IQRF DDC kits. To open your project, please go to the IDE project and run the example EOO start. IQRF IDE will be launched and the project opened. Our task will be to create a wireless transmitter and receiver. We will use the example EO1TX and EO2RX. You can check and modify the code with a double click on the source file. Here you can read the description of the application and the code itself. As you can see, there are no more than 10 lines of code to send the packet. We will change the message and the number of the bytes to be sent out. We save this file and go back to the IQRF IDE. You can check the code of the receiver as well. In this case, it's not more than 6 lines of code. Another step is to compile the source code so we get appropriate hex files. You can do it with this button or with F10 on your keyboard. Then we need to connect a module to the IDE. We use DSStart03 or DSDPA01 and plug one of the modules into the programmer. We connect the programmer to the computer, and that's what we can observe in this corner. You can double click here to read the device details or push Ctrl M to read the module details. In this case, we are using DCTR52D with operating system 3.05. Let's say we want to change the channel we are communicating on. To go to the TR configuration, you can double click here or use this button. Here we can set up an RF band and select the channel. Let's say we will use the channel 32. We will save this configuration and close the window. Now we have everything ready for the upload. The first file we want to get uploaded is the transmitter hex file, and we add the configuration. We run the upload with F5 or this button. Now we have the transmitter ready and we plug it into an evaluation board. We take another module and insert it into the programmer. We upload the receiver hex file and the same configuration. Now we have the receiver ready as well. When you push the application button on your evaluation board, the packet will be transmitted and received by the other module. You can read the data in the IDE terminal log. In the same way, you can use other examples, modify them, and integrate them into your application. This is how you can work with IQRF transceivers. How you can work with IQRF data control transceivers will be demonstrated on another video. So, start making your products wireless. It's simple. This video is just a small piece of a complete IQRF video tutorial set. To get a full picture and understanding of the IQRF technology, please watch previous and following IQRF tutorials.